Roll sound.
Rolling. Take one.
Hi, today we're talking about diagnosing and treating cancer with light. I said diagnosing and treating cancer with light. Bob was supposed to turn that thing on, but looks like he's still playing that Simbrains game. There you go. Diagnosing and treating cancer with light. Ta-da! All right, I think I know how I can get through to Bob. Can I have that for a second? Then down, left, right, left. A, B, start. So this is our whole body. The cells are going about their lives, following the body's natural rules, populating the different neighbourhoods, the organs. Cancer though, well, cancer is playing a different game. What happens is, one of the citizen cells rebels and becomes a cancerous cell. It starts building an underground neighbourhood with its own set of rules. These neighbourhoods are what doctors call tumours, and since they don't follow the body's natural rules, they start growing out of control. Eventually, they need more space and invade the other neighbourhoods. And these neighbourhoods have their supplies hijacked, making them weaker and weaker. Finding where these rebel cells are and where they came from is not easy. They live deep underground and can be very silent. So, if the problem is that doctors don't have a map of these cities and can't see clearly inside them, do you know what can help? Light. I bet you remember that we can use near-infrared light to see things inside our bodies in a non-invasive way, right? Because of light scattering and low absorption, the photons can go deep into the tissue. So when we use light to see these underground rebel neighbourhoods, we can see the traffic, the blood flow and the amount of oxygen around them. As you can see, in tumours, blood flow can be higher and more chaotic. So when we use light to identify the blood flow, we can easily see which neighbourhoods are normal and which ones have tumours in them. And light can also be used to treat cancer and get rid of these underground neighbourhoods. We can send in agents to infiltrate these cancerous areas, and when they're deep inside, we use light to activate these deeper agents, signalling them to cause havoc inside these neighbourhoods. Some of them produce toxic air. Some of them light fires to take down the buildings. When we treat cancer and remove the tumoral cells, blood flow goes back to normal. We can then use light again to look at how this network of blood vessels and oxygen is changing and see how well a cancer treatment is going. See? Using light, we can more easily find and treat cancer. What did you think, Bob? Isn't that exciting? Is this a multiplayer game? Bob, let's head outside for a minute. You're spending way too much time with this thing. See, let me explain to you what a metaphor is.